Hey fellow backyard boyers, Nick here. Now, seeing that today is April 1st, I got to thinking that it's been a while since I've done a funky bow video, and the double-limbed center shot bows come to mind. So today I figured I'd make a different kind of double-limbed bow with you guys today. Now this double-limbed bow has lots of different names. They're different particular styles, and generally, a lot of people refer to it as a Penobscot bow or a Micmac bow, father and son bow. Basically, it consists of two bows, a main bow and a helper bow that sits on the front. Strings run from the helper bow to the main bow, and this gives you a couple of interesting things. One, it brings up the draw weight. Two, it generally increases the speed a little bit without a lot of extra limb mass. And another thing it also does is it gives you adjustability. You can actually adjust the weight of this bow by how much tension you have on this front bow. So it's kind of a neat way to make a bow. So to get started, you're going to need two pieces of pipe. I'm using 3/4 inch Schedule 40 PVC pipe. My main bow is 52 inches long. I've gone ahead, marked the center, and then mark 3 inches out from center, so I have a 6-inch handle. And then I've also marked 6 inches from each end. My helper bow is quite a bit shorter, 30 inches long. I've marked the center, and then 6 inches total for the handle, 3 inches out from the center. That way both handles match. And then I've also marked 3 inches from each end. So now I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to flatten these out, and I'm going to start off in the center with a 1-inch spacer block. So I'm going to start with a 1-inch taper and taper flat to the ends. I'll show you what that looks like. Once the pipe is soft enough, line it up straight on the jig, and then press it. And again, I'm using a 1-inch spacer. Here's one limb tapered. Now you just want to do this for the other limb and the other bow. All right, now that we've got both of our pipes flattened to a taper, it's time to shape the handles. I'm going to start off by shaping the main handle. I've got my heat gun here, and I'm going to heat from this mark to the other mark. So this total of 6 inches in here. I'm going to make sure that's heated up, plus a little bit on the outside. This is going to require a little bit more shaping than most other bows, simply because we want a good connection for these two pipes, because we're going to stick them together. So, here we go. Alright. Now you want to take this, place it on a flat surface. You want to shape the handle. And we're doing two things. We're squishing from the sides, but we're also pressing against our flat surface because we want the back of the bow to be as flat as we can possibly get it. That doesn't have to be super perfect, but you just want it to be fairly flat. And while we're shaping this, we also want to make sure that the handle is nice and consistent. Okay. You can see fairly flat on this side. I'm just going to press it in just a little more. And then, as a finishing touch, you just want to sight down the bow and make sure both limbs line up straight through the handle. Right. There's the handle on our main bow. Now we'll put that on the side, and you want to heat up this mini bow, or the front bow. Here we go. All right, now that this is done, same thing we did on the other side. And we just want to press the center while making sure that the back is completely flat. Now this doesn't have to be super flat, there can be a bit of roundness to the back here. But what we're trying to do is we're trying to press the pipe out just on one side. We want this belly to stick kind of proud. That way, when we've finished shaping this and we attach this to the other bow, there will be some clearance in the lips. Okay. Just press it in. Just make sure that it's straight through the limbs or through the handle. And there it is. Now we're going to put them together. Or at least we're going to make them fit together. And this is how they're going to go. You can see. Pretty straightforward. So to do this, take our heat gun and heat up just the belly side of the handle, just the belly side of the handle. Okay. So now that the belly's heated and you see just the belly is shapeable, you want to take both bows, line them up, and press the front bow against the main bow, like this. You want to press fairly hard and get it to really stick. While you're doing this, you want to make sure that both bows line up and that they're fairly straight. And we can do some additional adjustments later, but it helps if you get them to stick together pretty well right now. It is. Now that the handle is shaped, it's time to work on the tips. I'm going to heat up the last 6 inches until we meet this mark. I'm going to heat up the last 6 inches until it puffs out. Then I'm going to crimp the end in this vise and do a little bit of reflex at the tip. Now you don't need to use a vise for this. You can use the edge of your board, but I'm going to be using this today. So here we go. One thing when you're heating up the tip, you want to start by heating up the flats until it starts to puff out. Do not put heat on the edges, otherwise they may split. And now that the end is heated up, you're going to take your pipe, make sure that it's lined up. And then you want to crimp the end. A little bit more here. That's about good. Tighten that as much as you can. And then I'm just going to shape this tip until I have a couple of things going on. I have a nice transition into the lip, and I have a little bit of a recurve here. And there it is. Now I'm going to let this cool. Once this is cooled, I'm going to go ahead and do the other side. Now we're going to form similar knocks in the helper bow. I'm going to heat up the last 3 inches of the tip. And we're going to make a smaller version of a stubbier version of what we did on the main bow. Here we go. Alright. So now we're going to put the end in the vise. and put a bit of recurve into this, just a little bit. This right here is a good angle. Not quite 90 degrees, but...
looks good.
And just let this cool. Once this is done, I'm going to take this out. Here it is. Now I'm going to go ahead and do this side, and then I'm going to cut this off and clean it up. Now that the tips are done, it's time to cut our string knocks. We're going to be cutting two knocks on each tip of the main bow. We're going to do one in the normal spot on the front. That's going to take the normal string. Then we're going to do one a little lower on the back, and that's going to connect to the helper bow. So we'll start by doing that. You want to measure on this particular tip. I'm going to be doing it just about a half an inch from the bottom here. Now if we were to use if you had done a different style of tip, say you left this flat, and you just cut corners out, then this would work for both strings. You don't have to do anything special. But for this, you need to cut a little bit of an extra knot down here. Now, one thing to keep in mind is, when you put your main knock in, the only consideration is that you need to make sure that where your string knock goes in, anything below that is untouched, because the load is all coming down here. So with the helper string, we want it to sit on a different plane, and so we want it to sit a little further up here. And when it's being pulled in, the stress, we don't want it to be in the same area or it could snap the tip. So I'm just going to go about half an inch from this bottom here and just cut pretty much straight in. And go until I just cut through the wall of the pipe and then round it off. There's that. I'm going to turn it around and go about a half an inch from the end of the pipe and cut in till I get right through the pipe wall. There you go. Then I'll just round off these ends. And there are my knocks. Now on the helper bow, I'm just going to cut a simple knock from the end, half an inch from the end. There it is. So now I'm going to sand and smooth everything off, and then we'll put the two bows together. Now it's time to put the two bows together. The first thing that I'm going to do is string up the main bow, and I've made a temporary paracord string. So here it is strung up. This is going to be the top one. So now I take my smaller bow, the helper bow, line it up in the middle, and I'm going to put it together with duct tape. Now I've made several of these, and the first couple were made with a connection of duct tape. And of all the ones that I've made, the ones that held out the best and actually are still working are the ones that were connected with duct tape. So it may not look pretty, but it works really well. The thing with the duct tape is that once you wrap this bow, you can always cover the duct tape with something else, with leather or paracord, whatever you like. So when you're doing this, you first want to just line this up and make sure that your marks all line up. And then just tape these two together tight. Now since we know which side is the top limb, we can go ahead and tape up the bottom of the handle. Here's the bow taken down. Oh, I took the string down. Now you want to tie a couple of knots and make your temporary string for the front bow. And something to keep in mind is that this is adjustable. So as you go on and use this bow, I highly suggest using some sort of twisted bowstring or twistable bowstring, because you can really adjust the weight of this bow by how you twist it. Well, what I'm going to do here is, on the first stringing, you want this to be very lax. You want this to be relaxed when you string this up. Otherwise, you could collapse this whole bow. If you try to get a lot of tension here right now, you could collapse the whole bow when you string this up. So I measure about 2 inches away from the tip and tie my knot. As you can see, it goes on and there's no tension on the string right now. Now that I've got this, I want to tie another one just like it. So I'm going to do that and I'll show you what it looks like. Alright, I've got 2 strings that are the same length. Now it's time to attach them to the bow. So put one on the helper bow, put it on the main bow and the helper bow. Make sure it stays on. And do the same thing to the other side. Main bow, helper bow. Make sure that the string is locked into this nock. Now that you've got this, take your main string, place the smaller loop on the bottom nock. And for this, I'm stepping through. So you want to hold just below the string on the other side. And you want to brace just inside of the string and on the handle. Slip the string on. Here we go. Here's what the bow looks like. So now it looks like I've got one side, the side that was originally weaker, is now actually a little stronger. Let's see. Let it settle a little bit. You know, that looks good. Okay. Here's the bow. Now let me draw this for you guys. Make sure everything lines up straight.
Let's go shoot it.
All right, here's the bow. I went ahead and I weighed it without the helper bow on the front attached. This bow pulls about 25 pounds at 28 inches. With the helper bow attached, the way these strings are right now, and you can see there's not a whole lot of tension on them right now, I'm getting about 48 pounds. So this thing's doing pretty good. I could probably tighten this up, and I'd say the maximum on this is probably going to be around 50 to 55 pounds at 28 inches. But I'll shoot it for you guys. Here we go. Here we are, 10 yards. Here we are at 20 yards. Here we are at the chronograph. Let's see how it shoots. There we go. All right. So this is it for today. Happy April Fools. And like I said before, on this day it's kind of a neat day to do some stuff I normally don't do. But at the same time, nothing here is fake. This is all real. It's a pretty cool bow. I've made several of these, and they're always great shooters. It's just finishing them, I always seem to have a problem. So maybe you guys will keep me honest and I'll actually finish this bow. But I always make them, I always love how they shoot, and I never really finish them. But this bow has almost no hand shock. The handle doesn't bend because you've got all of this stuff happening out here. And so it's really stable. I don't know if you saw, but it's a really stable shooter. So if you don't like a bend through the handle type of bow, this is pretty much your best bet for a short PVC bow. Here it is. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.